So going back here, with our four issuing order processor with perfect branch prediction, we have seen that our loop gets a CPI of 3 over 5, which is 0.6, without scheduling, and it gets a CPI of 2 over 5, which is 0.4, if we do scheduling on the original loop. Now let's see what happens when we unroll the loop once and try to execute it on this processor. This is the code we constructed, and now what happens in this loop is we do the load, the add has to wait for that result, the store has to wait for that. This load is going to a different memory element, so it can proceed in parallel with the store. The add, however, has to wait for that load, and then this store has to wait for that add, and then this decrement of the pointer can proceed in parallel with the store, but the branch has to wait for R1. However, then the load can proceed, and now we are back to where we started. So overall, it takes us 5 cycles to do these 8 instructions, which gives us a CPI of 0.62, slightly lower than the original unscheduled loop, but not much lower. So these are very similar in CPI. We still gain significantly from eliminating some instructions. So overall, this loop is going to perform better, but the CPI has not improved. But let's see what scheduling does after unrolling. In the scheduled loop, we will have our load for the first iteration of the two that we are really doing. And now if we put the add here, it would again have a dependence, so the load and whatever we already did here would be the only thing that can be done in this cycle. So instead of doing the add next, we will look for what else can we do here that doesn't depend on this load. And it turns out that this load here, the load for the second iteration, can be done in parallel with this load. However, we cannot store the value into R2, so we will have to use another register, let's say R10, for that. So these two now can execute in the same cycle, and if you remember, so could the branch. Now that we have done this, we can do the add for the first iteration of the loop, and also the one for the second iteration of the loop, in the same cycle. And in the same cycle, we can do the add I instruction for moving the pointer. Now these two will produce the results that the stores need, so next cycle we can do the stores. Note, however, that this is the store that was supposed to store with offset 0 from R1, but here we have now decremented R1 by 8, so now we need to store to 8 from R1. That's because this store needs to match the address of this load, but the R1 has moved in between. And then for the other store, we're storing R10 now to the address that used to be -4 from R1, but R1 has already moved by -8, so now we need to store to 4 from R1 to match the address of this. This is basically -4, and then we did -8, so now we need to add 4 to that in order to get -4, and now we can do our branch. So now let's see what can we get on our processor. In the first cycle, we will be doing these two loads that can now proceed in parallel. The add here, however, cannot proceed in that same cycle because it needs the result of this load. However, this add and the next one and this one can proceed in the second cycle. Then the stores here have to wait the results of the add, so they cannot proceed in the same cycle. However, they can be done in the next cycle, and so can the branch because the R1 has been produced, and so can the load because R1 has been produced. And unfortunately, in this cycle, we cannot do this load because we already executed 4 things. So unfortunately, that load is done in the next cycle, after which we get the same schedule as here, the 3 adds and so on. So overall, it took us now 3 cycles to do 8 instructions, which gives us a CPI of 0.38, slightly better than the scheduled CPI for the loop that we didn't unroll. So what really happened is unrolling gives us more stuff that we can reorder here so that we can find more things that don't have dependencies. And thus, for example, we were able to do these two loads that were not available prior to unrolling. If we unroll this loop 3 times, then we would have 4 loads here that can all proceed in the same cycle. We would have 4 adds here that can proceed in the same cycle, 4 stores that can proceed in the same cycle, and then the add and branch equals. So the more we unroll, the more parallelism we can get, simply because there is now more instructions among which we can try to find independent ones. Keep in mind that unrolling already reduced the number of instructions, and with scheduling, it allows us to also reduce the CPI. So it kind of creates a double whammy for performance improvement. Our execution time gets reduced both because we have fewer instructions, 8 instructions per 2 iterations, as opposed to 5 instructions originally for 1 iteration, and also after scheduling, it gives us usually a better CPI.